This video explains how to use CRP5 to solve fuel calculations, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the sixth video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. The CRP5 navigation computer uses the 60 index throughout this lesson on fuel calculations. The lesson is divided into three parts and will instruct you in the method of finding fuel required, when given fuel flow and time. Finding fuel flow, when given fuel quantity and time. And finding endurance, when given fuel flow and fuel quantity. Throughout this video, I will use the white line like shown on the screen to represent CRP5 inner and outer scale. Below the line represents the inner scale and above the line represents the outer scale. Fuel required. To calculate the amount of fuel required, given a fuel flow and known flight time, align the 60 index against the fuel flow per hour. Then, read off the amount of fuel required on the outer scale against the flight time on the inner scale. An example would allow us to demonstrate the correct method. Given a fuel flow of 8.6 gallons per hour, a flight time of 2 hours 40 minutes, calculate the fuel required. As always, we get an approximate figure to allow us to judge the scale of the answer. Round up 8.6 gallons per hour to 9 gallons per hour. And 2 hours 40 minutes to 3 hours. We get our approximate value of 27 gallons, so our answer must be somewhere around that area. Align the 60 index with 86, representing 86 gallons per hour on the outer scale. Next, align the cursor with 2 hours 40 minutes on the orange scale, or 160 minutes on the inner scale. Read the answer on the outer scale. 22.9. Our approximate figure tells us that the correct answer must be 22.9 gallons. Fuel flow. Fuel flow is also known as fuel consumption rate. To calculate fuel flow given fuel amount and flight time, set the time on the inner scale against fuel amount in gallons or liters on the outer scale. Read the fuel flow from the outer scale against the 60 index on the inner scale. We use an example once again to make the mode of operation clear. What is the fuel flow if 18.4 gallons have been used in 3 hours 20 minutes? To get the rough idea of the magnitude of the answer, round up 18.4 gallons to 18 gallons. And round up 3 hours 20 minutes to 3 hours. Then mentally divide 18 gallons by 3 hours, which gives us somewhere in the region of 6 gallons per hour. First, align 3 hour 20 minutes on the orange scale or 200 minutes on the inner scale with 18.4 on the outer scale. Using the cursor will help us to get an accurate answer. Read off the answer against the 60 index. 55.2. From our approximate answer, we know that the correct answer is 5.52 gallons per hour. Endurance. To ascertain aircraft endurance, given the fuel flow either gallons per hour or a liter per hour, align the 60 index on the inner scale with fuel flow on the outer scale. Next, align the cursor with the total fuel quantity on the outer scale, and read off the endurance on the inner scale. An example will help you to see the procedure being used. What is the aircraft endurance, given a total fuel of 48 gallons and fuel flow of 8.6 gallons per hour? First, we get the approximate figure. Round up 48 gallons to 50 gallons. Then, round up 8.6 gallons per hour to 10 gallons per hour. We then mentally divide 50 gallons by 10 gallons per hour to give us the rough answer of 5 hours endurance. Initially align the 60 index on the inner scale with the 86 on the outer scale, representing fuel flow of 8.6 gallons per hour. Next, align the cursor with 48 on the outer scale. Read off the figure on the inner scale. 33.4. Our ballpark figure implies that our endurance is in the range of 5 hours. Therefore, our answer is 334 minutes or 5 hours 34 minutes. Note, this answer in hours and minutes can be read directly from the orange scale. In the next video in these videos series, we will discuss on true airspeed, below 300 knots. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you next time.